bulimic, huh? Brother, okay, he's with you. So look, while you waiting on the light, we want to holler at you real quick. Believe in God? What's the name of your God?
God.
So believe in the God of the Bible.
Okay.
Let me show you a couple things, right? Let me do the Deuteronomy 22:5. I want to see if you really believe. Yep. Respectfully though, because a lot of times all people say they believe, but you don't believe in this action.
I haven't been into my Bible, so
that's
I'm
respect.
Not gonna lie.
Okay, you kept it 100.
I am a God of the Bible.
Okay, let's get the dress code. Give me 1 Timothy 2:11. Just give me a modest book. And give me the word of the Lord. Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22:5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So what do women wear that men wear?
Leggings
is fine. If it's, but what do we normally wear? That women wear? What every man on here got out there, got on? What kind of clothes? Pants, right? Paul, the zipper right here, like you know it's for men, right? Well, what's the word on? What is a garment or a clothing for a woman?
Pants, leggings.
Nowadays, right? But in the ancient times, it wasn't so. You know when you go into the bathroom door, they show you the difference, how you know the difference between a man and a woman?
Because
it's simple, but what the woman is wearing.
Exactly.
You're out of order. You don't know that, but I'm saying you're out of order when you wear clothes. It'll be no different for me wearing a damn dress. You're looking at me strange.
Oh,
exactly. So you get what I'm saying? We looking at, our women don't know and respect, you know? Elders and moms, they don't know these things. That's why we gotta come out here like, what's going on? Y'all got caught up with this feminist movement in the 1950s and told us, y'all, on the same level as men, and that's not the case. You see what I'm saying? And now a lot of our women is on this independent black. God is bullshit. You know what I'm saying? I'm keeping it a buck. And that's not scriptural.
It's not. Right.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right.
So, you know, we come out here to educate our people in a respectful manner. You know what I mean? Like, man, you're talking, right? I'm going to give you one more and I'm going to let you fall out. You know what I mean? One more. Give me that one.
This one.
Yeah. 1 Timothy 2:11.
1 Timothy 2:11. In like manner also, that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Modesty, right? What you think modesty means?
Respect
yourself, all right? Get the porn on. That's right, you're right, to get the porn. Like, how can a woman show that she has respect for herself in the way she dressed?
Not wearing provocative clothes,
then
I'm kind of
out here. Absolutely, right? So now look, a lot of our women is on this, you know, ambiguous freedom, liberation type of time, right? Now look, we didn't write this. You know what I mean? We just a messenger. I'm sure you heard the saying, don't shoot the messenger, right?
Yeah.
Read it again.
And likewise, I mean, in like manner also, that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Modest apparel, right? Modest, that means you covered up. You're not showing any of your private members but to your husband. Our women, less is better. Less is more. Loose the eggs, thong, fishnets, we doing the most. That's only for your husband to see. That's not for the works of the Lord to see. You see what I'm saying? Lord said, cover up, hold yourself in class and dignity. Over, great, 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 great parents, they weren't moving like that. Nobody see their nakedness, but they hug. Now, I can go on Twitter and see everything. Twitter, Instagram, oh man, I see her, bro, every team busted open. She did everything for us.
No, for real.
It's madness out here, man. And then they got the nerve to say, we're not free. What are you talking about, sweetheart? How are you not free? You know in the Middle East, women get killed for showing their face?
Yes.
You talking about you're not free? Right, they fully covered. You get what I'm saying? Our women is speaking madness. We come out here and try to slap some sense back into our people, right? Modest apparel. The Lord said, adorn yourself with modest apparel. Watch this.
And shamefacedness is so bad.
Goes on what you said, shamefacedness. Order. You got some pride about yourself. You know what I mean? Our foremothers were real classy. Now we're not classy. We're just hoes. Oh, what's the next? What's another word for hoe? Because we at another level. I know
Harley.
Thought.
I said a Harley.
A Harley, that's the Bible. Yeah, the Bible term. She used the biblical term. That's where we at right now. That's what a Harley is, though. I'm having sex in exchange for money.
Sneaky link. Yeah, that's what they call them now, my sneaky link.
Sneaky link. Our sisters are pulling off, man. OnlyFans. It's empowering them, man. OnlyFans. That's digital prostitution, sweetheart.
Yeah.
You are showing man for $5.99 a month for you to bust it open and have another man bust you open on camera. That's so poor. Absolutely, so they growing it great. I don't remember the dudes that I grew up in, I don't remember a two-parent house. No cap, I'm not saying it wasn't, I'm just off the top of my head, I can't remember my homies, I don't remember, now we had our problems, but the houses were broken. It was dysfunctional. You know what I mean? I've never seen a household where both parents were there. It was very rare. And that's crazy. We normalizing things that's not supposed to be normal. Right? Think about Asians. Asians, do they grow up in broken households? Why is all this happening to us? This is more deeper meaning on why these things are happening in survival. I'm going to show you one more. I know one more because I want to touch on this, right? A lot of people don't know these things is subjugated, that we subjugated to over here in America, is biblical prophecy. Read that. Continue.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So that's prophecy. The Lord said, it's going to come to pass. I mean, I'm going to tell you a story that's going to happen at a later point. Right? That's the prophecy thing. Tell you a story and it happens at a later time. I'll tell you right now and then it happens maybe two different.
You said what?
The Mandela letter? Yeah, like the what? You said the Mandela effect? Okay, similar to that.
Read.
To observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Is a curse a good thing? Because the Lord said, look, if you go against my commandments, you heard of the commandments, right? I'm going to allow these curses to come upon you, right? Now let's get some of the curses. Give me the one I want. No, not that one. I want the single parents. 54.
It's the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 54. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eyes shall be evil towards his brother, and towards the wife of his bosom, and towards the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
He's going to do what to his children?
Which he shall leave.
He's going to do what to his children?
Which he shall leave.
What are our brothers doing to our children?
Leaving.
That's not coincidental, though. That's biblical prophecy.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? The reason why is because we went against his commandments. That's crazy. Give me that Isaiah 3:12. You know what I'm saying? Isaiah 3:12. We having these things just happening to our people, man, because we went against the commandments of the Heavenly Father. We went against the Heavenly Father, and as a result of us going against the Heavenly Father, we are subjugated to these damn curses. And the only way to get out of the curses is to come back to the walls of the Heavenly Father.
That's what we got.
Come over here.
Isaiah chapter 3 and verse 12. As for my people, children are their oppressors. The women rule over them.
Women what?
Rule over them.
Women what?
Rule over them.
Women is ruling over us. Would you? I mean, is that an accurate assessment? You think so? Read it again.
As for my people, children are their oppressors.
A lot of these women have been raised, you know, raising in single parent households. I'm trying to read. So the children are running the household. Probably not in your household, but you know you've seen that. I'm sure you got nieces and nephews that run their parents, run circles around, right? Read.
And women rule over them. What? And women rule over them.
What God means by that is that they have been raised in fatherless households, and as a result, the women are calling the wars. The natural order for a woman is to fall in her feminine role and to be submissive to her king. But because the man is not there, so you have to have women be masculine and be the provider and be the protector for their sons. But that's not always a good recipe.
It's not.
It's a bad recipe.
For the woman and for the son.
Oh, absolutely. It's gonna call her living hell because look, little Ray Ray, right? Let's just keep it above. Little Ray Ray, right? He gonna be working with his mama, he love her, but it's gonna come to the point where she talking about he ain't listening to. And mama gotta go get the bread. She gotta go work. Right? Mama gotta go get the bread. She probably working 12-hour shifts. She probably can't afford daycare right now. So who? She gonna probably have grandma watching. She's gonna come a time with grandma and get tired. She's like, I'll raise my kids.
Yeah.
So little Ray Ray got old. Little Ray Ray ain't listening to mama and granny no more because it's not applicable. Where he gonna turn to? He'll turn to the streets. The streets ain't gonna teach him nothing but how to hate his brothers.
Hello?
You see what I'm saying? And that is a recipe that our people are going to, and it's been regurgitated for generation after generation after generation. When are we gonna stop this madness? When are we gonna stop this madness and come back to the Bible, man? Because the Bible teaches how to fix all. That's why we are here. How to fix these things, right? They teach how to reinvent the wheel when we already got a perfect script. All praises. All right, appreciate you, sis. Man, clap it up for her, man. All praises the Most High, man. Huh?
Brother said, can he be an Israelite in the Most High?
No, you cannot. And look, and did I tell you in the spirit we're going to go over here? All right, let's go over Islam, right? Let's bring it out, all right? All right. So what is it to be Muslim? I guess technically what the word Muslim means to submit to God. But your God is Allah. It's a false deity. Allah's not a real God. Right? It's a lower deity, man. Let's bring it up. Bring out Allah. Look it up, man. Look up Allah, the lower deity, right? Let's go into Babylon of Timbuktu. Somebody get the Babylon of Timbuktu. We're going to go into this history, man. Islam. Right? We're going to see where your religion begins. Read that.
Allah, the name of God in Islam, historically originates as a moon god.
As a what?
As a moon god. As a moon god.
No, you cannot be with this and then submit to a moon god. Because that's what you submit to, brother. You submit to Allah, you submit to the moon god. You know what I'm saying? Keep reading, because it's more on that, right?
Yeah. Historically originates as a moon god, originates in early 20th century scholarship. The word Allah is a common Arabic term for the supreme god and is widely used by Arabic.
Absolutely. Allah just means God, but nevertheless, right? No God is a moon god, man. So hell no, we can't intervene here. That's what we submitted to. Is the brother still on there?
Yeah, probably.
He's still on there? No, you can't. Respectfully, though. We ain't coming for you. You can't do that, brother. Bring it up.
Matthew chapter 6 and verse 24. No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other.
You gotta pick one, bro. Why the hell you want the moon god when we got the real god right here, man? That don't make no sense. Why you want the watered down fake, make believe fairy tale God, but we got the real Heavenly Father right here. It don't make no sense. Read. No, that's good. That's good on that, right? You got to pick, man. Choose this day. Make sure you choose wisely, brother. Yeah. Let's go into Islam. Let's go into the origins of it. I want to go into the origins of it. Give me the Babylon Timbuktu real quick. We're going to the history of Islam. We're going to talk about your so-called prophet Muhammad, right? Who's seen a vision or heard a vision from the angel Gabriel, right? Let's see if that makes sense. Now look, this is a cold thing about the unholy Quran. The unholy Quran said that you have to submit to the Bible. That's the commandment in your unholy Quran. That's one of the scriptures in your unholy Quran. So if you gotta submit to the Bible, then we're gonna go ahead and bring out the Bible. But we're gonna bring out these verses in the Quran, and we're gonna see if it makes sense. We're gonna see if it makes sense. Matter of fact, give me Psalms 147, verse 19 and 20. Right? Now, there's a proclamation for the so-called prophet Muhammad that he received a revelation from the angel Gabriel. And through this revelation, he recited it, and that's how you got the Quran, right? Well, let's see if it makes sense, because in the Quran, it says you have to submit to the Bible. Let's go ahead and see what the Bible says.
You know, the book of Psalms, chapter 147 and verse 19. He showed this word unto Jacob.
No, he showed it to Muhammad.
He showed this word unto Jacob.
The Aram.
He showed his word unto Jacob.
Oh, he showed his word to Yahshua. So you can cast out the prophet Muhammad right there by that one scripture. He only showed his word. He only recited his word to Israel. If you're not a part of these 12 tribes, he's not dealing with you. Period. Read.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He has not dealt so with any nation.
He dealt with nobody else. Read.
As for his judgment.
As far as the judgments of the heavenly Father.
They have not known.
They don't know. Because the Most High ain't dealing with them. And we know that no God is to do his commandments. They ain't never going to do the commandments. Because they're not in experience to do so. Read that. Give me your verse, your 45, you know what I'm on. Get,
Babylon in Timbuktu, page 45. When Muhammad was born, many Arabs were still worshiping the sun, stars, spirits, and idols.
So when Muhammad was born, the Arabs were worshiping idols. It was heavy idolatry. So before Muhammad was born, for those who don't know, Muhammad was born 600 years after Christ, man. 600 years after Christ. So I always like to ask Muslims, like, what were you doing before Muhammad was born? Let's go into it, man, because the historians documented what these damn Arabs were doing before Muhammad, right? We're going to show you all what they was doing. Read that again.
When Muhammad was born, many Arabs were still worshiping the sun, stars, spirits, and idols. The Arabs possessed 360 idols, one for each day of the year.
So that's what the so-called, you know, Prophet Muhammad and them boys in Saudi Arabia was doing, man. They was into idolatry. They had an idol for every day of the damn year. Prior to the so-called Prophet Muhammad, I'm going to say so-called because he didn't prophesy the damn thing. He plagiarized the Bible and copied and pasted and customized it for himself. Right? And y'all can't, y'all, and I wish a Muslim would try to come out and debate it. Because we're going to go into the history of your so-called prophet, who's a damn liar. Right? Your so-called prophet's a liar. He didn't prophesy the damn thing. He learned everything from the Jews and customized it and had a slight different variations, man. And put his own spin on the story. Right? That's what the word Quran means, to recite. What did he recite? He recited the words of the Jews.
Man. Us?
Right?
What you mean, go down.
Huh? Lies, what are you talking about? You don't know your history. No. You can look up at any publication. You don't know what you're talking about. You're going to keep bringing it up. All right, what lie did we tell?
He said Muhammad couldn't read or write, so how could he
He recited. That's what the word Quran means. He spoke it. That's what the word Quran. Go look up the word Quran. That's what it means, to recite.
Right.
He spoke it. And we're going to get into the reading and writing.
After Muhammad became a camel driver, he traveled to remote and intriguing lands. He led his caravans to Persia, Syria, and Egypt, transacting business with merchants of every kind. On his business trips, he met Jews.
He met who?
He met Jews.
On his business trip, he met who?
He met Jews.
That's how he got the Quran, man. He recited it from the Jews, right? Let's go to when he couldn't read the right. Where is it now? Right here. Read that.
Muhammad was born AD 570. His mentality, oh God. In his youth, he was never taught to read or write.
He was never what?
In his youth, he was never taught to read or write.
Familiar with that. We know he can't read or write. So we know damn well he didn't write it. You know what I'm saying? He recited it. That's what the word Quran is derived from, the word Quran, which means to recite in Arabic. Read.
But his imagination was superlative.
Absolutely. He had a superlative imagination, man. What did he do? This is crazy stuff in his damn Quran. Read.
Muhammad was an extraordinary handsome man, an eloquent and motivated man with the power of words. In the early years of Muhammad's life, he passed his time as a shepherd boy. You must remember that many successful men have arisen from insignificant and humble conditions.
Absolutely, man. He rose from humble conditions into the status of being able to rule Saudi Arabia, right? And he eventually had, you know, Mecca, which is one of the main cities in Saudi Arabia. Nevertheless, we know that, we're familiar that he couldn't read or write. But where did he get his information? Let's flip over. We're going to see where he got his information. Got it from our forefathers. Everything that he did is customized from the Bible. Yeah, you know what I want. Is it 47? Now we're going to get into that. We're going to get into the unholy Quran.
Page 48, Islam and Judaism. The Prophet Muhammad adopted many principles and laws from the Jewish religion.
He adopted what?
Many principles and laws from the Jewish religion.
Jewish customs, man. What do you think he got all his understanding from? The Jews. He came and healed up our rabbis and our teachers. And this is how he was able to get the understanding. What's going on, bro? All right.
The basic idea of monotheism, which is the belief in one God.
basic ideas of monotheism is a belief in one God. As you see, the Arabs were serving other gods, many gods, right? Until they got introduced to this concept by the so-called Prophet Muhammad. Where did he find this process? Where did he find this concept? You see?
First of all, the basic idea of monotheism, which is the belief in one God. The Jewish confession of the unity of God, the Shema Yasharala Adah,
The belief in one God. Belief in one God came from our people. Shema Yasharala, man. Read.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
The Lord our God is one, man. He got that whole concept from us. Let's keep reading. Let's see how he customized it and changed it to his own belief.
The Mohammedan.
You turn back out. It's a lot, y'all. Israel, man, we bugged out, man. That's why we got to come out here, man. Israel is in the world of their own. They act like they don't see that America is falling down right now. And that it's time for us to wake up and come back to the laws of God, man. Man, read that.
The Mohammedan slogan is as follows. La Allah, 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 Muhammad, Rasul Allah. There is no God but Allah. Muhammad is a prophet of Allah.
See how you switch that up? Right? He tried to take our slogan, Hero Israel is one Lord, our Lord. Right? He switched it up and said, there's only one God. That prophet, that one God is Allah. You have to listen to the prophet Muhammad. He customized everything, man. He's on the fly just making things up. Let's keep it going. Read.
Muhammad adopted also the main details of the Jewish calendar.
Also adopted the details of the Jew calendar. Right, read.
The Day of Atonement.
The Day of Atonement. That's where Ramadan comes from. The Day of Atonement. Let's read about it.
The Sabbath.
The Sabbath, right? The Day of Atonement, the Sabbath. They took and covered all that and customized it to his own version. Read.
Much of the Bible and narratives from the Midrash and many points of the ritual law. Incidentally, the Jews pray three times a day facing the city of Jerusalem.
So we pray three times a day facing the city of our Heavenly Father, which is Jerusalem. Read.
And the Muslims, true believers, pray five.
True what?
True believers.
True believers.
Pray five times a day facing the city of Mecca.
Where did he get that from? Where did he get that from, brothers? Where did he get that from? It's in the Bible. Give me the one in Daniel. Let me show you in the Bible. And you're not a real Muslim if you don't go to your pilgrimage, man. You got to go on your journey and present your Hajj. If you don't present your Hajj, you're not a real Muslim, man. According to your religion, that you have to go the pilgrimage to Mecca, circle the Kaaba stone seven times, and bow down and pray to it, man.
That's right.
And if you don't do that, then you're not a real Muslim, according to Orthodox Muslims. You don't want to deal with that. Read that.
The book of Daniel, chapter 6 and verse 10. Now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house, and his windows being open in his chamber towards Jerusalem.
Towards where?
Towards Jerusalem.
The Holy Land.
Towards Jerusalem, he knelt upon his knees three times a day.
Three times what?
Three times a day, and prayed and gave thanks before his God.
See, they covenant in our Bible, man. Now look, the prophet Daniel lived hella long before the so-called prophet Muhammad. You know what I'm saying? Hella long. We talking about centuries and centuries, man. Where you think he got that from? You got that from my Bible, man. Customized it. Let's keep it going. I'm going to this bullshit religion, man. Let's keep it going. Where you stop at? Here. Go right here. Try.
From Babylon to Timbuktu, page 48. Trying his best, Muhammad sought to convert the Jews to his new religion.
He tried to what?
To convert the Jews to his new religion.
The nerve of him. First of all, he learned from us. Then he said, turned around and said, y'all gotta join me now. That's like somebody coming part of BOW and is like, you know what? I'm gonna start my own camp. Y'all gotta join me now. We ain't BOW no more. We are men of Israel. We Galileans. You know what I'm saying? That's what Muhammad tried to do. He said, I'm learning under y'all, but now y'all gotta come under me. Madness, right? Read.
The Jews were adamant and resistant to change. The high esteem which the prophet held for the Jews was transformed to enmity.
Transformed into what?
To enmity.
So he had a high esteem and a luxurious affection for the Jews, but it turned into enmity because we didn't want to go and subscribe to this bullshit religion. So as a result of that, he started hating us. So that love that he had at one point in time turned into enmity and enmity and hate. Read.
And instead of allies, he looked upon them as competitors.
As what?
As competitors.
He's trying to compete who's going to have a bigger religion.
he looked at us as allies at one point in time, because we've been in Arabia hella long, way before the Prophet Muhammad was ever thought of. Get a precept. Give me Galatians 1:17. Right? They don't know nothing about their history. Whoever that brother is, I don't know if he's playing or he's sincere. If he's sincere, you better get a dose of this. Yeah, let him come on, man. And let's see if y'all can defute this, man. And we ain't even brought out none of the bullshit verses in the Quran yet. We're going to bring out the Quran and the Hadith. Read.
The book of Galatians chapter 1 and verse 17. Neither went I up to Jerusalem to them which were apostles before me, but I went to Arabia.
Went to where?
To Arabia.
Went to where?
To Arabia.
This is during the time of the apostles, man. We're talking about 40, 50 AD. We've been in Arabia. What are you talking about? We've been in Arabia. Jews been up there. Paul had his voyage in Arabia. What are you talking about? Read that.
Muhammad needed the confirmation of the influential Jews to validate
his... He needed confirmation from who?
From the influential Jews.
He needed confirmation from the influential Jews, because we are an influential, illustrious people, and everybody knows that. This is why... And look, don't try to think on a basic level of Hebrew Israelites right now. I'm talking about on a monumental level. It'll be no different from doing business with Drake. It'll be no difference with doing business with Oprah, doing business with Michael Jordan, doing business with LeBron. Right? These are men and women who accomplish the highest level you can accomplish. And a lot of other nations want to cleave to them and do business with them. Jay-Z title, right? Jay-Z title ain't his deal. You know what I mean? He got that deal from another nation. And they put him as a face. Just like they put him as a face for Brooklyn, to promote the Brooklyn Nets. They always do that. They need us to validate and substantiate what they're doing. Right? Read.
To validate his mission. As all upstarts need the backing of someone influential.
Every upstart needs somebody influential. Who's more influential than us? Nobody. This is why you always see us being endorsed and on commercials and putting us on billboards. Because you put us on things, it pop. Read. Look at Cardi B. Hey, anything she touches is going to be gold right now. Even though she's wicked as hell. But nevertheless, she has the influence. Read.
Muhammad therefore turned against the Jews and became their tormentor.
Turned against the Jews. It became our tormentor, man. Let's keep it going. Let's get this right here.
Muhammad tried to construct his religion as closely as he could after the Jewish religion.
After the what?
After the Jewish religion.
So the Prophet Muhammad, so-called prophet, constructed his whole ideology and his principles and his heritage after the who?
After the Jewish religion.
After the Jews' customs and heritage. Right? Where do you think he learned all this from? From us, read.
He favored the Jews by accepting many of their laws and traditions.
The laws, like for example, not eating pork, the Sabbath, Ramadan, all that is from us. Multiple lines, you learn all that from us. And our Bible, read.
When the Jews refused to be converted, he commanded his followers to stop turning to the holy city of Jerusalem in prayer, but rather turn to the city of Mecca.
So when he got mad at the Jews, he said, don't turn to Jerusalem no more, turn to Mecca, read.
He changed the Jewish Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, our fast day, which he had accepted for the month of Ramadan. Muhammad changed the Jewish Sabbath from Saturday to Friday.
Absolutely, so he just was customizing things on the fly, making things up. I don't like that, I'm gonna change this. I don't like that, I'm gonna change this. Who the hell are you to change anything, man? This is what your religion is based on, brother. I hope you're still on here watching. This is what your Islamic religion is based on, this man right here. There's no other prophet before him, and there's no prophet after him, according to y'all. Madness. Read.
We have another parallel with Christianity. In the 4th century, the church changed the Sabbath to Sunday.
Let's put on that. Salakia. Give me you right here. In order
to win the pagans into the church, Christianity adopted many barbaric customs and traditions. Likewise, Muhammad, to gain the loyalty of the pagan Arabs, adopted many of their beloved customs. The cobblestone. An idol.
A what?
An idol.
A what?
An idol.
That cobblestone's a goddamn idol, man. Y'all circle around it 7 times when you go do your pilgrimage to Mecca. You circle around it 7 times and then you bow down to it. Give me Leviticus 26:1. Most High God said that we don't supposed to bow down to no damn idols. We're supposed to bow down to no damn idols. According to the scriptures. Flip it over. Read that.
The book of Leviticus chapter 26 and verse 1. He shall make you no idols nor graven images.
Now watch how the Most High, he's so cool. He said, don't make no idols or graven images. Watch this.
Neither rear you up a standing image, neither shall ye set ye up any image of stone in your land.
Image of what?
Of stone in your land.
Did we not just go over the cobblestone earlier, brothers? That's a goddamn standing image that they bowed down to and circled around seven times when they make their pilgrimage to Mecca. Madness. The Lord told us not to do it. And in the Quran, it says the Torah is the light. Now, let's read the Torah one more time. I ain't going to cut you off all the way through.
Book of Leviticus chapter 26 and verse 1. Ye shall make you no idols, nor graven images, neither rear you up a standing image, neither shall ye set up any image of stone in your land.
Absolutely. The Lord specifically said, don't put no damn stone in your land and bow down to it, right? But they went against it, totally against it, because they heathens and they devils, man. And they don't belong in the Holy Covenant, right? Read that. I'll read it out.
The black stone, according to Islamic belief, Muhammad is credited with setting the black stone in the current place in the wall of Kaaba.
God, that black stone, which is really a vagina. When you go into it, it's really a vagina, man. You know what I mean? It's really a vagina that they put on that Kaaba stone, man. In their religion, you know what I mean? For those that don't know, in certain parts, not in certain parts of the Middle East, they got their women in control. In certain parts of the Middle East, the women had more respect than the men. Certain parts. And brothers that was coming over there were surprising to see that, like, damn, how she got more status and respect than you do? That don't make no sense. It's a new thing in us, right? Read that. Got the fireman coming out, man. This is just regular LA stuff, man. It's always madness in LA. I promise you, it's not a Saturday we come out here and we don't see that. Read.
From Babylon to Timbuktu, page 50. The sword is the key to heaven and earth and hell. All who draw it in the name of faith will be rewarded. Muhammad became a martial prophet.
Became a killer. A martial prophet. Somebody that hated the Jews. Read.
And the pagans and stubborn Jews became his victims.
The stubborn who?
The stubborn Jews became his victims.
He killed our forefathers, man. The pagans and the stubborn Jews became his victims, man. Keep reading.
In the year 627, the battle of the false occurred. They did not hesitate in their choice. Muhammad carried out his hostile threat, executed the Jews, and the women were sold.
And the women were what?
Were sold.
Women were what?
The women were sold.
Women were sold. Right? I don't know if you're still on live. You still on live? You're still on live, man. The women, our women were sold. Our women were sold by the so-called prophet Muhammad. Look up the Arabian slave trade, man. They are proud to talk about it, man. They put our people in slavery, man. And it started off with the so-called prophet Muhammad, man. Rape, robbing, and murdering our men and selling our women and putting them in all type of places, man. Butt breaking the men. This started all the way back. What's going on, King? This started all the way back in Arabia. You see what I'm saying? Now let's get some bullshit scriptures out of the Quran, man. Let's get that Surah 2 and 121.
They said that's not in there. They said it's not in there.
Hey, tripping. Yeah, give me Surah 2 121. 122. Is it 122? Oh, this is the one about them putting hands on her, huh?
On the woman.
On the woman. Let's get that one. Yeah, let's bring that one out. Hold that up for me. Let's bring that out. Yeah, this is Surah. Hold this up, bro. Surah 434 to 42, but we're going to just read 34, all right? It says, men are the protectors and the maintainers of women because Allah had made one of them excel over the other. And because they spend out of their possessions to support them, thus righteous women are obedient and guard the right of men in their absence under Allah's protection. As for women of whom ye fear rebellion, admonish them and remain apart from them in beds, to deny them sex, right? And beat them. Beat their ass. I believe this is the Hadith. This is the Hadith. Yeah, this is in the Hadith. This is the Hadith. This is the Hadith. These are the so-called wise sayings of your Prophet Muhammad. This is your Prophet Muhammad wise sayings. You gotta deal with that. Now look, our Heavenly Father tells, now listen, put that bullshit down. So like, let's put that down. That's crack. That's crazy, right? Now let's go ahead and get the scriptures. Give me 1 Corinthians 7. Let me show you how the Most High said we're supposed to deal with our women, right? How we're supposed to deal with our women. The Hadith said, beat them and deny them sex. Give me 1 Corinthians 7 and read verse 3.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 3.
No.
Let the husband render to the wife due benevolence, and likewise also the wife unto the husband. The wife have not power of her own body.
The wife have not what?
The wife has not power of her own body.
Our heavenly Father balance, watch this.
But the husband, and likewise.
And likewise what?
Also the husband has not power of his own body, but the wife.
Right.
Defraud you not one another.
No, defraud people according to the damn Hadith.
Defraud you not one another.
The Lord said don't defraud one another, man, because you took this woman off the market and she can't commit adultery. So if she wanted, give her the business. When you want it, she need to give you the business. That's what the Lord said. Don't defile one another. But nevertheless, in the unholy Quran, right, it says you can defraud your woman's sex and beat her ass. Put hands on her. Right? Read.
Defraud you not one another, except it be with consent for a time.
Unless it be consent, that means an agreement for a time. But watch it.
That ye may give yourselves to fasting and prayer.
Fasting and prayer. When you're in the fasting and prayer, you want to deny the flesh and make sure you're living in the spirit. That's the only time you defraud your wife. Nevertheless, in this unholy Quran, it say, hey, beat the shit out your wife and put hands on her and deny her sex. Madness, man. This is what's going on in this unholy Quran. Let's get some more, man. Let's get another scripture out of here. Let's get the one in Surah. Surah 2, I want to say 136. Surah 2, 136 says that you have no choice. You have to subscribe to the Bible. It says you're a Muslim, you have to submit to Jesus, you have to submit to Moses, you have to submit to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
That's right.
That means you got to submit to the Bible, because we know Christ is the volume of the book. So now we're going to get the Bible, but I want to go ahead and get that. What's going on, big brother? What you say? Oh, you got it?
Chilling? Do you guys have anybody in Arizona?
I'm out here
just visiting.
Y'all here visiting?
Yeah.
You from AZ?
Yeah. No, I'm from Inglewood, but I moved to AZ.
Oh, you moving out there?
No, I moved already.
Oh, you moved out, okay.
And I'm coming back, I'm visiting. Okay. And I've been trying to figure out, because all I'm here is like IUIC, it's all, you know,
I'm not. Hey, get his number, big bro. Ramaya, get his number. We're going to tap in with you. We're going to stay tapped in. Give me that Sirach, too. 126? Nah, give me 121. Surah 122, 121. 122. I know it's in
it.
Yeah, read that. Surah, from the unholy Quran. Surah chapter 2, verse 122. O children of Israel, remember my favor that I bestowed upon you. My favorite, the Israelites, in the damn unholy Quran. So why the hell are we going to read this bullshit Allah book when we can read the Israelite book? Hold on. It's staying there. As you on it, go to the Bible. Go to their bullshit Bible. Please, go to it. It's in the 30s. I want to say 130, 32, or 134. It's going to talk about they got to listen to Jesus. They got to listen. Just type in Quran Jesus. Quran Jesus. Going to tell you that they got to subscribe to the words of Yahweh Shai, man. And we know Yahweh Shai come in the volume of the book. That means they have to be subjugated to the whole book. Now let's see who the prophet was. Give me Amos 2 and 11. Give me Ezekiel. Bring it out. We're looking for it, all right? While he looking for that, let's bring out some precepts. Give me Ezekiel. You know what I want. We got Amos 2 and 11. Bring that up.
38 and 17.
Amos 2 and 11. Bring it out. Amos chapter 2 and verse 11. Let's see who the prophets are. I rise up of you, your sons for prophets.
Your sons the prophets. Let's see who the prophets are.
And of your young men for Nazarites. It is not even thus, O ye children of Israel.
No, you children of Arab.
O ye children of Israel.
You children of Ishmael.
O ye children of Israel.
Yeah, children of Israel is the only prophets, man. The Most High ain't dealing with nobody else. He only showed his word to Israel. Yashallah, man. Contrary to popular belief. Read that.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 38, and verse 17. Thus saith the Lord God, art thou he of whom I have spoken in old time by my servants, the prophets of Israel?
Prophets of who?
Of Israel.
Arabia.
Of Israel.
Israel. Give me Nehemiah 4:17. We're going to run through these precepts.
Get out.
Nehemiah 4:7. Nehemiah 4:7. We're going to show you how the Lord hates them. Give me the Bible dictionary. Give me Israel. You brought it out? It's 131. Bible dictionary. Give me Israelite. We're going to bring our edification to the spirit, man. Hopefully they still watching, man. Y'all going to learn, man. Put that bullshit down, man. And then we see, and it's also in the high deeps, that it's okay to have black slaves. Matter of fact, Lob, look up that one. Black slaves. High deeps. Black slaves. The high deep. Read that. Come.
It's the book of Nehemiah, chapter 4, verse 7. But it came to pass that when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabians and the Ammonites.
The Arabians, watch it.
And the Ammonites.
Ammonites.
And the Ashdodites heard the walls of Jerusalem were made up.
They heard the walls of Jerusalem were being rebuilt. The holy temple were being rebuilt. These damn Arabians, watch what happened. Watch what they do.
And that the bridges began to be stopped. Then they were very rough and all conspired. It's like it. And conspired all of them together to come and fight against Jerusalem.
Come and fight against who?
Against Jerusalem.
What the Arabians do?
Fight against Jerusalem.
The Arabians fought against Jerusalem, man. They got to pay for that. They enemies of God. Write out the scriptures. The Arabians fought against Jerusalem. They are enemies of God, man. The Most High God going to deal with them for that. The Most High God ain't forgot about nothing. When we rebuilt the temple, our holy temple, they was mad. They was mad at it, and they was against it. They wanted to conspire a plan to break it down. Just like now, we're trying to rebuild the temple of Yahshua right now through the Spirit, and people hate us for it. Right? They call us a hate group. No, we just love our people and we hate evil, man. That's it.
That's right.
Read that. Ishmaelites.
Ishmaelite, a descendant of Ishmael, the son of Abraham and Hagar, the 12 sons of Ishmael and his Egyptian wife, became prince and progenitors of as many tribes. They live in camps in the desert of Northern Arabia.
Northern what?
Northern Arabia.
For the Ishmaelites?
Northern Arabia.
The Arabians or the Ishmaelites.
If I
flip
a book, it's like slaves. You're talking about the
slaves. Nah, I had the precept. I just on my phone. I had the precept. I see the game, y'all. Today. It's the precepts, man. In the unholy Quran. It's showing you how unholy this thing is. Nevertheless, I'll put it in the comment. I'll put it in the chat. I'll put it in the chat. It shows you that the so-called Prophet Muhammad owned black slaves. And let's look at Aisha.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Let's look at Aisha. Let's see that he's a pedophile. Let's see that he's a pedophile and he like to marry. Who said that?
You know, in the chat.
Oh, in the chat. Okay, give me Acts 5:30.
He said Christ is God.
Give me something going on, bro.
Christ ain't got no color.
Christ ain't got no color.
Man,
they not reading, man. They too ingratiated in Christianity, man. Even if we bring out the words, they're not going to believe it. Acts 5 and 30. Probably be shot
through.
What you got? You got the Acts, all right? You bring out the color of Yahweh's song.
It's the book of Acts, chapter 5 and verse 30.
Wake him up!
The God of our fathers raised up Yahweh's Shai, whom you slew and hung on a tree.
Read it as is, because they probably Christians, right? Read it as is.
Book of Acts, chapter 5 and verse 30. The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom you slew and hanged on a tree. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel.
I'll give repentance to everybody.
Repentance to Israel.
The whole entire world, like these Christians are saying.
Repentance to Israel.
Only repentance is for the Israelites, that's contrary to popular belief. Give me Matthew 1:21. Read that.
Read it out.
According to the unholy Quran, where it says you have to subscribe to the Bible. Now they're going to try to change the narrative in the words of the Bible. Go ahead, bring that up.
Surah 4, verse 157. In boasting, we killed Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, the messenger Allah. But they neither killed nor crucified him. It was only made to appear so. Even those who argue for this crucifixion are in doubt. They have no knowledge whatsoever, only making assumptions. They certainly did not kill him.
These niggas crazy,
man. That's
what
the unholy
Quran. They are crazy. They're trying to say that account didn't happen.
That's the Quran.
And that this make-believe. So they're trying to take
Man, this is not how you know he's an idiot. He just recited some stuff and customized it in his own little Arabic language, man. Messed up the whole damn story of our Lord, man. I ain't gonna deal with that madness, man. Let's keep it going.
The book of Matthew, chapter 1 and verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Let's see who his people is. Let's stay in Matthew 2, verse 6.
Book of Matthew, chapter 2, and verse 6. And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not thou least among the princes of Judah? For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people, Israel.
My people who?
My people, Israel.
People of the whole world.
My people, Israel.
Where y'all getting this concept that he came for everybody? Man? Y'all not making sense. We in the New Testament, right? Read that.
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14. Verse 1. The revelation of
The revelation of Jesus Christ, man. Reveal means to bring something in darkness to the light. Something that was in the darkness, you about to bring it to the light. Right? This is the revelation of Jesus Christ. Drop down.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
He said Jesus had a description. His head and his hair were white and woolly. Read.
As white as snow.
White as snow. Read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire. Uh-huh. And his feet were like unto fine brass.
Your feet is the same color the rest of your body.
As if they burnt in a furnace.
He said he had burnt brass feet. Burnt brass feet, man. Burnt brass feet is like us. Burnt brass, man. Jesus had a description. He looked just like us. So I don't know what the hell y'all talking about. Y'all don't read. All right, what else they saying? What else they saying? They saying Christ is God. Let's go ahead and dispel that madness. Man.
The book of John, chapter 14 and verse 28. Ye have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again to you. If ye love me, ye would rejoice, because I said, I go unto the Father, for my Father is greater than I.
Are we the same?
Where my Father is greater than I.
All you Trinitarians, man, y'all need to read y'all Bible, man. What did Christ say? It's written in red, as my brother said. Written in red. Read it again.
Where my Father is greater than I.
This is Christ speaking in his glorified state. He said, my Father is greater than I. There's no such thing as no damn Trinity. All right? That's madness. The Bible don't support a Trinity. Christ said, my Father is greater than I. Right? Got one? Give me Colossians 1 and 15. So all these Trinitarians, God the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, madness. That's not in the Bible. Read.
John chapter 6 and verse 32. And Jesus said unto them, very, very, I say unto you, Moses gave you not that bread from heaven, but my Father giving you the true bread from heaven.
And that's the bread. Christ is that bread. He said, my Father did it. It wasn't Moses. It was my Heavenly Father. Read that. Give me Colossians 1 and 15.
Read it out. Book of Colossians chapter 1 and verse 15. Who is the image of the invisible God?
Christ is the image. That's why he said, you see the Father, you see me. Read.
The firstborn of every creature.
First what?
Firstborn of every creature.
Creature. What's the root word in creature? Create. Christ was created. The Heavenly Father wasn't. That's why he's the Most High, because nobody created him. He's the only one. He's the self-existent power. Nobody created him, and he don't have an end date. He don't have a start or an end date. That's what makes him the Most High. Read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 3 and verse 12. Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God.
Look, Christ is talking. Written in red, as my boy Rob say. Written in red. This is Yahweh Shai Christ talking. He said, look, him that overcometh. Read that again. Read that slow for the audience, please.
Book of Revelation, chapter 3 and verse 12. Him that overcometh.
Him that overcomes.
Will I make a pillar in the temple of my God?
I'm going to make you a leader in the temple, in the house of my God. So if Christ is on the same level with the Heavenly Father, why is he in a subservient state right here? In his glorified body. In his glorified state. This is Revelation. This is the end. Christ already dead and gone. He in the heavenly realm telling John this. Make this make sense, Christians. You can't.
And he shall go no more out. And I will write
on that. I sit on that. It's letting you know the temple of my God. He's letting you know he's subservient to the Heavenly Father. He's the Son of the Heavenly Father. Give me Psalms 1 and 33. I mean, Luke 1, 1 and 30. Give me Luke 1 and 30, man. My brothers, y'all want to go up? Y'all brothers want to go up? You ready? You go? Watch. Want to go? Y'all got to get a little bit of burn, man. Get a little bit of burn. Read. 1 and 30. Luke chapter 1 and verse 30. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thine has found favor with God. And behold, thy shall conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall name, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest.
Son of the what?
The Son of the Highest.
The lowest.
The Son of the Highest.
We're on the same page.
The Son of the Highest.
The Son of the Highest. I mean, it's nothing higher than the Heavenly Father. We're on the same level. Y'all gotta wake up, man. He's the Son of the Highest, man. They still tripping?
No, they just talking about folly now.
They just talking about folly. How they going on, all right? Yeah, that's what happens when they don't know the Bible, read. Yeah. He's the Son of the Highest, man. What?
He said, he is
equal
to the
unless you're
scared of the
Word of God. Why? Well, I mean, for what?
Why
are
you
bringing it up?
Why you want us to
read
Ezekiel
23:20? What's in there? What's in there? Yeah, what are we talking about? It made no sense, man. So look, man, you want to go all up? Let's get back to rebuking, man. And let's get back to rebuking it correctly, man. Because we went into some doctrines, we got some edification. They going into folly right now, right? Yeah. The reason why we out here, man, we the Hebrew Israelites, we come out here to wake up the lost tribes of Israel, so-called Black, Hispanics, Native American men and women. We come out here to teach you guys who you are according to the Bible, man. All right, you guys are the 12 tribes of Israel, whether you like it or not, whether you accept it, believe it, disagree with it or not, whether you like it or not, we are the chosen people of God. And we have a requirement. Because we the chosen people, Black and Hispanics, we gotta come back to the Heavenly Father, right? Give me Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Y'all go? Okay, come. Y'all ready?
Y'all
go first?
Ain't no, we gotta go. Bring them out.
Get y'all right. Yeah, 10 and 12. Let's rebuke a little bit. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12. And now Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of
you? So-called Black and Hispanic, the Lord said, I require this of you. Read.
But to fear God.
Y'all don't fear God. The so-called Black and Hispanic man don't fear God. Last thing is, God is not on their mind. They worrying about pussy right now. Where the next club at? Where can I go find a thought? Where the next function at? That's what our people is finding out and going through right now. Right? Who can I slide and ride on? Game banging, popping pills and shit, right? That's what our people into, right? Right, but the Lord said what? Read it again.
And now, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee? What does God require of you? Read. But to fear the Lord thy God.
Fear the Lord thy God.
To walk in all his ways.
To walk in all his ways. Are y'all walking in the ways of the Heavenly Father? I think not. Right, my 10 tribe brothers, why I got a little extra. Right, the sister walked by, she had a nice body. They looking and breaking their neck, man. Like they ain't seen a pretty woman before. God, for God's sakes, we in LA, man. We see them type of women all the time, a dime a dozen, man. And they ain't saying it's a wrong thing to look, but damn, you lusting and about to break your damn neck, gallon out your seat. Damn, man. Come on, man. We don't got no focus. We don't got no decorum or control of our own spirit. Discipline, man. Zero. Right? Zero. Who we out here doing? Lusting. We got that lust demon right now. Want to have sex with everybody, right? They don't want to take up the responsibility of having sex with the woman, right? That's what our people went to. Read.
And to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and all thy soul, and to keep the commandments of the Lord.
And that's what this is all about. We come out here to teach the commandments of the Heavenly Father and the faith in his Son, man. That's why we out here, man. The commandments and faith in Christ. And by the way, Christ's not a damn white man with blue eyes. All right? That's madness. It's documented in the Bible how he looks, all right? He looks like us. And we come out here and we raise awareness to our people, man. And I'm going to end it with a death to America.
Death to America. I say the pop.